talk about chestnuts and ergots. Chestnut, I think, is some also herb or tree that it's called a horse chestnut. If you look it up, so you may get that tree. But we're going to talk about chestnut on horses. They're also called night eyes. And what they are is basically that little, looks like a rough area right on a horse there. And that's a chestnut. Some horses have them on the front and back. Buddy has one on each leg here. Get around this other leg. And that's a chestnut right there. And his are kind of flat. Some get kind of thick. If you look at this from an angle here, it's flat along his leg, so it doesn't protrude out. Big T over here has a little bit bigger ones. His are a little bit more intrusive, and they look a little rougher. He's got more wildness in him. And people will peel these off, but they're stiff. But you can, as you can see, I can just kind of peel that off and pull that off, and it kind of crumbles away as it dries. But this kind of hurts him, and it doesn't feel real comfortable. So what I do is either rub a little baby oil on it, or some Corona with some lanolin, or any type of lotion, and that'll make it peel a lot easier. And they don't do anything. Again, they're called night eyes, but I don't like picking them draw because it hurts the horse and it doesn't feel good. And again, Big T here has them on both sides. It's called a chestnut, or some people call them night eyes. The old horse whisperers used to say if you peel off a chestnut and you put these in your pocket, it gives you horse whispering capability, and the horse will see you as a horse. Some theories behind where these come from is it's connected to the hoof that used to be a toe, and others say it's some sort of scent organ. So if it's a scent organ and you peel them off, put them in your pocket, somehow I guess a horse thinks that you're a horse and it'll somehow listen to you and you can horse whisper. And again, that's just one of those old crazy snake oil sayings. Again, some horses have these in the back. Tanner does have them in the back. You can see it right there. Just a little chestnut. And again, it's pretty stiff. So I don't like to peel them when they're hard like this. But I would rather lotion it up and get it off. They don't hurt anything. And that's called a chestnut or a night eye. Now the other thing is called an ergot. And an ergot is comes from a French word, rooster spur. And it's right on the bottom of the fetlock here. And usually it's common with horses with feathers. So you see these feathers here that Tanner's has? And a lot of your giraffes have these. And some of your prehistoric wilder horses will have feathers. I'm not sure why or whether it keeps them warm or why they have them, but cold bloods tend to be in colder climates, so I think it just keeps their hoof warmer maybe. But an ergot is a little bitty point right in the back of the hoof here. Hopefully Big T will let me get a good boy, I know. And I gotta dig through all his fur here, and there it is. See that little, I don't know if you're going to be able to see that little point there. But right there, that's an ergot. And again, it's like a spur, like a rooster spur, and that's where it comes from. And they don't hurt anything, and your horse probably won't have them, but he doesn't have them, because he doesn't have feathers. And a lot of your draft horses will have these feathers, your Clydesdales and all that, you know, the pretty feathers. Tanner loses these sometimes later in the summer, but in the winter he grows them out. And that's a chestnut and ergot. They don't really hurt anything. Some people let them grow long. They're more of a human thing that we want to keep them neat and peel them off. I just say if you're going to peel them off, put some lotion on them the day before, or a little Corona or some baby oil, and the next day when you come out, they just roll right off. It's nice and smooth. It doesn't hurt the horse, and it's a lot more comfortable the horse. Now, can you peel them off? Some people grab those to get a horse to lift their foot. Grab the chestnut. That'll make him lift his foot. Well, it freaking hurts. That's why he lifts his foot, because he's trying to tell you, you're pulling on me and it hurts. So I don't like using those. Again, it's a human thing. People want to clean them up. Supposedly it's a sign of bad horsemanship. If you let your chestnuts grow really big and they become, you know, real long, they'll naturally peel off, they'll naturally fall off, they'll naturally flake off. But again, from a just taking care of your horse, people like to peel them off and keep them short. So that's a chestnut and ergo. And if you hear somebody say a horse chestnut, make sure they're talking about the chestnut on their legs and not the tree or the plant or the herb, whatever it is. Hope that helps. Thanks, Big T.